fan, so by the title you know today I'm going to be sharing my top 3 into eye as well as lip category. Yes, I have only done a part 1 where I did show you my top 3 into makeup category, base and face makeup. Yes, I could have included this segment in that video, but then the video would have gone like 3 hours long, which I really don't intend to do. So without rambling too much and giving you all the information, let's get started. Video, let's start with some eyeshadows. So yes, it was very difficult for me, a person like me who keeps buying too many eyeshadow palettes, to pick out 3. But these 3 eyeshadow palettes I do end up using a lot. They are part of my eye makeup routine. I relate with these kind of shades and I feel these 3 eyeshadow palettes are done to perfection. The quality is good and yes, I do myself using it as much as I can. I do feel there are like certain shades wherein I can hit pan on. First up, let's talk about a palette which I'm wearing on my eyes today. It is one of my favorites and when you will see this palette, you will understand why. It's the Brown Sugar, Karoche and ColourPop collaboration eyeshadow palette. I don't see it anymore on the ColourPop website. If you happen to get it, then do look out for this one. Now this is a well done, stunning, warm eyeshadow palette. It just sits perfectly well. It complements any Indian skin tone, I would say. And the best part is that the shades are well placed. You have like a cooler tone, you have a warmer tone, you have shimmers, and you have some well done shimmers. You don't have those typical shimmers here. So yes, I really like putting these shadows on my eyes. This is one of those palettes wherein I travel with. I can just pack one palette and I'm sorted because I'm not a person who wears too many bright colors on my daily basis. So yes, this is one palette which I have enjoyed the most from the time I've got it. This is one of those most used palettes into my ColourPop family as well. And I'm not giving away this one to anyone because I know the looks I get from this, I'm more than happy. And I always get some stunning look out of this palette. This is a palette which I can wear it with my no makeup makeup look as well as a good glammed up makeup look. So yes, a palette which I love for the quality, mattes, shimmers, blendability and the number of looks I can get out of it. Talking about my kind of palettes, there's another one which I feel is a little out of the box and I feel this is one of those palettes which can never go out of fashion. And a lot of you will enjoy this one. Is the Makeup Revolution Neutral versus Neutral palette? Yes, ye abhi bhi hamare vanity mein hai. Quite surprising. It is a 2.5-year-old palette. I remember saving so much money to buy this one. Ab to hum kuch bhi le lete hain. But when I started my YouTube journey, this made it to my eyeshadow family. And from that time, it has just stayed with me. Just not stayed, but have been part of my makeup routine. Again, a palette jahan pe aapko bahut achhe shadows milte hain. You just don't get browns, you get like peaches, some berries, some nice shimmers. The rose which you see down below, oh my god, the shimmers are so well done. And you can get so much out of it. This palette is very close to the Modern Renaissance. The first Modern Renaissance palette, oh my god. I couldn't afford Modern Renaissance and when I saw Antariksha doing a comparison video, I was like, ye le lete hain. But I must tell you again, इधर भी quality बहुत अच्छी है. मैं काफी use करती हूँ इस palette को. You can see it for yourself. I'm about to hit pan on certain shades like these top, these 4 shades. Oh my god, I'm going to finish them. Then you see these shimmers. Already they are like deep down to the pan. So I do use this palette again a lot and I totally relate with it. Every eyeshadow you use or every eyeshadow palette you have a story to tell. So this one definitely sticks by me and I don't see myself getting rid of it just because the number of shadows it has and the shadows which perform really well onto my eyes still, and I can still further use it as long as I want because I know I'm gonna love these kind of shadows for a very long time. Talking about another eyeshadow palette which I really like quality ke liye bhi, dusra eyes do use these shadows a lot. And aapne mujhe kaafi bar aise looks mein dekha bhi hai. More peachy, orangey, not too loud, but soft and soft glam looks. This palette comes really handy and sare shades isme waise hi complement karenge looks ko. Is the K-Beauty Pure Bloom palette. Initially jab mujhe ye palettes mile the, I was more towards the bare soul, but as and when I started using this one, mujhe isse zyada mohabbat ho gayi. And I must tell you, this is again something which is just like kept on my vanity. It's super dirty. I use this a palette a lot again. Now I'm going to hit pan on this one soon. I feel this shadow here, the mattes, oh my god, again my kind of shadows. I just love wearing this palette. The quality is up notch. The only shadow which I feel performs a little less for me is this one. Leaving this, all the other shadows like are wonderfully done. So if you're a person who looks for a palette which will complement your no makeup makeup look, this is the one to go for. So a stunning palette by K Beauty, wonderful mattes, good shimmer, color payoff is nice, stays well on the eyes, and I absolutely love it. Again, a palette which I feel is not too much talked about, but it is definitely one of the best I have used, and this definitely fits into top 3. So after knowing the top 3 eyeshadow palettes, let's move on to some more eye products. So first up, I'm going to show you some kajals which I love wearing, but I have recently done a video on complete 7 kajals where I did talk about 7 smudge proof transfer proof kajal. That is a separate video altogether. उसको आप बाद में देखो, आपको और ज़्यादा काजल वाले ऑप्शंस मिलेंगे. बट टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू 3 काजल्स, व्हाई आई लव देम, व्हाई दे मेड इट टू टॉप 3. फर्स्ट अप, आई हैव अ काजल विच इज़ लाइक माय होली ग्रेल काजल, कलपा जस्ट स्मोकी काजल इन द शेड ब्लैक. देर इज़ नो कॉम्पिटिशन टू दिस काजल. आई फील इट इज़ वेल डन. इट इज़ अ स्मच प्रूफ, ट्रांसफर प्रूफ, अ काजल विच जस्ट स्टेज ऑन टू माई वॉटर लाइन विच आर बचिंग एंड गोइंग हियर एंड देयर. So yes, for this reason I absolutely love it and I keep buying it. So whenever this kajal gets over, I repurchase it. So this is not my the first kajal, this is my 3rd kajal by Kalabar in 3 years after having so many other kajals. Talking about another one is the inexpensive kajal. Ye maine isi saal kharida tha, ye launch bhi isi saal hua hai, but I absolutely love it again. Is the Nykaa Black Magic kajal. Now frankly speaking, I love all Nykaa kajals, like they have done an amazing job on their kajals, I must say, and this one is very good. Now this is not a smudge proof or a waterproof kajal, I would say you have to go in with like multiple touch-ups. But I'll tell you, jab mujhe kajal lagana hota hai na, jab mujhe bas lagana hai kajal, this one I just pick it up, because ye kajal main bina mirror ke bhi laga leti hu. It just like one stroke mein lag jata hai. Black kajal hai, pigmented hai, रहता है वाटर लाइन पे, बट आई डू फील यू हैव टू गो इन विद लाइक मल्टीपल टचअप्स. सेइंग दैट, द काजल इज डेफिनेटली गुड, लाइक आई लव वेयरिंग इट. आई ऑलरेडी हैव अ बैकअप ऑन दिस वन एज वेल, सो यू नो हाउ मच आई लव इट ऑलरेडी. एंड द लास्ट काजल विच आई लव बिकॉज ऑफ द फॉर्मूला अगेन दिस काजल फॉर सम पीपल कैन बी अ लिटिल ट्रिकी बिकॉज इट इज सुपर स्मूद इन टेक्स्चर. ये स्मज प्रूफ कम्प्लीटली नहीं है, बट विंटर्स के लिए बहुत अच्छा काजल है. इज दी फेसेस कैनेडा इंटेंस जेल काजल. ये जेली काजल है, आपको स्टिक फॉर्मेट में मिलता है. द बेस्ट थिंग अबाउट दिस काजल इज सुपर स्मूथ, इज सुपर बटरी. द कलबा वन इज ड्राई फीलिंग काजल, बट बहुत अच्छे से लग जाता है. बट ये आपको लगाते वक्त भी बहुत सुपर स्मूथ काजल है. विंटर्स में मैंने क्यों इंसिस्ट किया ये काजल, बिकॉज मैं इसे विंटर्स में बहुत ज़्यादा इस्तेमाल करती हूँ. Even in like initial summers and monsoon weathers, maybe I like using this kajal, but when the weather gets humid, I stay away from it because it gets super smooth on my eyes. But a kajal which I have loved for years and years, and this is again my 3rd or 4th, I cannot do without it. But it is definitely not smudge proof or waterproof. I feel in summers thoda jaldi wear off hota hai kajal, but again intensely black hai. You know, leaving all those points, I still go back to it because it is black and it applies easily. Every product has a pro and a con. There are very few products which have like 10 on 10 everything. But saying that, a con doesn't make a product bad. A con is something which can be adjusted or you can just fix it. There are a lot of fixes in makeup. Makeup is all about, you know, art and craft, I feel. So yes, those 3 kajals which I showed you, 2 of the kajals have a con, but I still love them because the formula is such. So yes, everybody has a liking. So if you don't feel that you would like to get a kajal which is not smudge proof, don't buy it. But if you are expecting a kajal which has to be smooth and buttery, then I just showed you 2 options. But do check out that kajal video. Let's talk about some eyeliners. So I have a lot of eyeliners, and a lot of eyeliners have gone bad. In my case, past 1.5 years was not a very good journey, but lately I have been finding some good ones as well. But the three eyeliners which I can just blindly use it on my eyes and recommend anyone, and I will go back and repurchase it. One of them is the Swiss Beauty eyeliner. Oh my god, this is one eyeliner which I can just buy like 10 of them and keep it in stock. One of the best eyeliners. 250 ki aati hai ya 299 ki aati hai, I think they have raised the price on it. Oh my god, you wear any kind of eye look, ye eyeliner easily lag jata hai. It's a pen style felt tip eyeliner, jet black, smudge proof, and it just stays. So yes, I have absolutely loved it, and I think it is my 5th or 6th eyeliner and already have a backup. So you can imagine how much I love it. Next up, an eyeliner which I will repurchase it soon because I think it is almost done, is the Sugar I Won't You So double matte eyeliner. Again, something I've used the most, and mere paas zyada liquid liners aise format mein nahi hai. I have only 3 or 4, and out of which one is already over, one other one is already like over, so I have to repurchase this one. Again, a super matte black eyeliner which stays well onto the eyes, felt tip hai iska bhi tip, and it just helps to get that nice eyeliner going on. Though you have not seen me using my liners to do wing eyeliners because meri aankhon pe wing eyeliner acche nahi lagte, that is why you always see I do my eyes eyeshadow more of an extended eyeshadow outwards. That gives me more of a nice wing. Agar main ek eyeliner se wing banaungi, I look very cartoony. Yeah, but eyeliner is a very important step, and this one really fits in. So if you want a good quality liquid eyeliner, try the Sugar one. And the last but not the least, something very recent, but maine iska already backup khareed liya hai, so you can imagine how much I already love it, is the Kiro Beauty waterproof soft matte eyeliner pen. Oh my god, I'm so late in trying this product, but jab se maine Kiro Beauty ke products try kiye hain, I've been looking out for more, and I'm just waiting if they launch anything new. So yes, this is another felt tip eyeliner, jet black, bahut aasani se lag jata hai, waterproof hai, smudge proof hai, and I just love it because it is very well done. Like, it's like 900 rupees ka hai ye liner, and I just feel that it's like well done, perfect eyeliner hai. I don't mind paying 900 rupees, and I will keep using it. And frankly speaking, aajkal main yahi liner sabse zyada istemal bhi karti hu because I just like the way it sits onto my eyes. Now before I jump into mascaras, let me show you 2 brow products. Now brow is a tricky portion. There are 2 brow pencils which I use the most, and I have repurchased them again and again. One is the Faces Canada eyebrow defining pencil, which comes with this spoolie at the other end and the pencil. Ye meri 3rd pencil hai, and I will go back and repurchase it. I'm in the shade tan, I think tan 01, and this is one of my favorite holy grail brow products. I think this brow product actually made me buy more brow products, built up that confidence in me to try more and do my brows. So yes, bahut hi achhi pencil hai. Bahut logo ko thodi zyada pigmented lag sakti hai, but agar aapko filling ke liye chahiye aur aap easy peasy brow routine chahte ho, to then this is the pencil to go for. Another brow product which may not interest you, but let me tell you frankly, khareedo, lagao, come back to me and tell me you have found one of the easiest brow products, is the Colorbar brow crayon. Wow brow crayon, ye kuch aisi aati hai. It's a fat brow pencil, typical desi style wali brow pencil hai ye. Is pe bahut sare fibers hain. It fills in your brows, it helps to shape up also. You just need an extra spoolie. I don't mind picking up extra spoolie, and I'll tell you, I have a backup on this product. Ye meri dusri pencil hai, I already have a backup because this is one pencil can just do my brows in less than 30 seconds, both the brows. Yeah, so yes, a wonderful product by Colorbar. It's very underrated, nobody knows about it, I feel nobody talks about it. But agar abhi tak aapne aisa kuch product try nahi kiya hai Colorbar se, to I will tell you, get it. I have the other pencil also, the spoolie one. Any day I will take this over any brow product I have. So this one again has to be my like top 3, though I don't have the number 3 brow pencil, but this definitely falls into that number 1 category. So do try it. Let me know how you felt about it. But this is definitely my obsession. I have to have this product. If you have been following me, you know I'm not a falsy person, though I do end up buying too many falsies. I do wear them occasionally now because I have got the right ones for me. But I'm more of a mascara person. A good mascara, a very good mascara plays a very important role. And even the technique plays a very important role. But if I really have to talk about three, then these are the three which just come straight up to my mind. First up, I have the Huda Beauty Legit Lashes Mascara, which I'm wearing as of now. Frankly speaking, as in when I have wore this mascara more, I've realized you don't really need the two ends together. You can just wear one end at a time and you will still have lengthening and voluminizing. This I really wanted to point out here because jaisa maine kaha na, as you wear the product more and more, you know how you can use the product best. Like today I'm just wearing the curling and the lengthening and it has done an extremely well job. Mujhe volume add hi nahi karna pada. So yes, a good mascara for the price. I do feel it is a well priced mascara because you're getting two different mascaras in one packaging. I know it gets a little hard on the pocket at one go, but agar abhi tak aapne ye mascaras nahi try kiye hain, the Huda Beauty one, le lo. You will thank me later. Okay, next up I have an inexpensive mascara, and the mascara I've used the most again after the launch is the Nykaa waterproof mascaras. Oh my god, this is like the dead on combination. Why I'm picking both? Because I use both together. So I do first curling and then I go with voluminizing, or sometimes I do voluminizing and then do curling. But these are the two best friends, won't together well onto my eyes. Waterproof hai. And the best thing about this mascara is waterproof hone ke bawajood na aapki aankhein heavy feel karti hain, ye bahut easily nikal jate hain. Dusra, you get a lot of time to build up your mascara. So yes, another wonderful mascara jo maine bahut zyada istemal kiya hai, and I think I have to repurchase it. And last but not the least, a mascara which I have been using past 3 years. Saying that, I'm not saying that ye jo bullet maine haath mein pakdi hai, ye main 3 saal se istemal kar rahi hu. This is my third purchase. And ye main Instagram se khareed leti hu. Is the Tarte Tarteist mascara. Oh my god. I'll tell you one thing. Agar aap Huda mascara nahi lena chahte ho, mat lo. Aap ye kisi bhi Instagram page se le lo. Ye aapko 1200 ki aayegi. Maine ye li thi The Beauty Lounge India se, because that is one page jo Tarte ke orders place karte hain. And they generally have it in discount, in stock. And ye mujhe 1200 mein mil jati hai mostly. So this is one mascara which can give you lengthening, voluminizing, and it just lifts your lashes. Again, a wonderful invention. Mere makeup routine mein bahut kaam aata hai ye. I have to repurchase it. Abhi bhi hai isme thoda bahut product. I will use it. And maybe in the Black Friday I'll place an order for this one. But this is definitely one of the best mascaras I've discovered in 3 years, and it has been there with me for 3 years. So I have gone back, repurchased, gone back, repurchased. Though maine aapko jo bhi mascaras dikhaye wo sare main repurchase karungi, because I love how they make my lashes look. I really don't have to go in with a falsy. So after discovering top 3 into eye category, let's move on to some lip section. Now my god, lipstick gets very difficult. So let's get started. First up, I have only 2 lip liners because I have never tried anything apart from these. These are the only 2 lip liners I use. Like multiple shades I have, but the 2 formulas I use and I love. First up, I have the K-Beauty lip liner, which is like my holy grail. This actually made me buy the other one I'm going to show you in a minute. Oh my god, they have some stunning shades, amazing formula, increase the longevity of your lipstick. Oh my god, I just love it. I can wear this lip liner with any lipstick, any formula, and it just adds up. So I can actually wear this lip liner without a lipstick also. So there are days I just wear the lip liner, I just top it up with a gloss, and I'm done. So yes, this lip liner is a must do. Next up, a liner by Nykaa, which I absolutely love. Not the shade, I would say, but the formula. Again, a formula which is definitely worth trying. They have added more 6 shades. I'm going to buy 2 shades at least. Again, I can wear this by itself. Nobody would come to know that I'm wearing a lip liner. People would think that I'm wearing a nice lipstick only. Again, I love wearing this underneath my lot of lipsticks, and nowadays I do include a lip liner underneath my lipsticks just to increase the longevity, as well as since we are wearing a lot of masks, a lip liner basically gives that nice pigment going on all through the day, even if your lipstick starts wearing off. So yes, this lip liner also plays a very important role. I have like 4 to 6 shades. I'm already eyeing more, so you can imagine how much I love those two lip liners. So my battery died. So my timer went off. So let's move on to the next segment, lipstick. Now yes, there are way too many lipsticks in my vanity, way too many formulas, but if I really have to pick up only 3, then I think these are the only 3 I can take out and think of, and just my hand just went on these 3, because I feel these are the 3 formulas I have worn the most, as well as shades, you can call it. And I don't want to say that these are my 3 favorite shades, but they have definitely made it to my favorites as well. First up, I have the Colourbar Sinful Matte Lipstick. Oh my god, you need to try them. This is in the shade Sin. I have worn this shade the most, as well as the whole lipstick range. I have like 6 to 7 shades, and I wear them quite often. Whenever I'm going out in the evening, I end up wearing this lipstick a lot. Reason being, it's super rich, it's highly pigmented. Even underneath the mask, it stays well. It doesn't transfer on my mask, at least. But saying that, they are not transfer proof. They do transfer a little bit, but a super rich lipstick, and I really like it. Saying that, another rich lipstick, but a little less expensive than the Colourbar one, is the K-Beauty one. Oh my god, again, a wonderful range of lipstick. They have some stunning shades to choose from, and I love this shade by them, Cameo. Another wonderful shade. I think I have to repurchase this one. This is the most worn shade lipstick of the year 2021 as well, and I still use it. I travel with it, I live on it. I can just endlessly wear this shade by K-Beauty and the formula. Again, it sits well underneath the mask. And last but not the least, a formula which I don't see a lot of people talking, but it is definitely a must try. I would not say that you're going to love this formula in winters, definitely not, because it is a complete dry down matte lipstick, but I can still wear it in winters because I just like it on my lips, the way it makes my lips look, is the Sugar Matte Attack lipsticks. I have like 4 to 5 shades, and I love all the shades. This is by far one of the most worn also in 2021. You can see it's already in sight. Is the shade called Salmon Republic. One of my favorite shades to wear. Oh my god, you cannot just get enough of this. This is a complete dry down matte. So when you apply it, is buttery. Just give a settling time of 30 seconds and dry down completely to matte. The best part, they do not transfer on your mask at all. Even if you're eating food, these lipsticks stays on really well. Maybe this is also one of the reasons that I was wearing this lipstick a lot, because we do wear a lot of masks, and whenever I'm going out, I just don't like doing touch-ups, and this lipstick comes really handy. Ye lipstick maine bahut pehni hai, and definitely it is one of my favorites and go-to. Agar Sugar future mein bhi aur shades add karega, toh I will end up getting more shades. But definitely worth trying and one of my favorites. And now we are down to the last segment of this video, lip glosses. Now I'm a person who likes to wear glosses. Today also I'm wearing a lip butter. Now lip gloss is not supposed to be bought in multiple shades. If you like lip glosses, then try investing on good ones. But the 3 I'm going to show you work absolutely well on my lips, and I like this kind of a consistency on my lips. Everybody has a liking on lip glosses, so accordingly get yours. But these 3 I think are the best. First up, I have the Colourpop Ultra Glossy Lip. Now this is the newest shade in my hand, but there is one shade called Bluesy I have worn the most. I still have it. Oh my god, I just love the formula. I like the applicator on these glosses, and they are just so rich, juicy, and they just give you that nice shine. Like, they are definitely high shine glosses. So if you want to add that nice gloss, like oomph to your lips, you know what to get. Let's move on to another one which I love the most, but it is not everyone's gloss. Like, not everyone would like it, because it's not like like the one I showed you earlier, is the Nykaa Glosses. Now this is in the shade Honey Boo. I like it because it is subtle. It's not too much on the face. Like the Colourpop one is like right on top. Like you will just feel, oh my god, her lips are like juicy. This one is not juicy, but it's going to look very subtle and nicely done. If you're a person who doesn't like to apply too thick or heavy glosses, then you want to love this one. I really like the shine on this one as well. But the only thing is, like, when you start eating and sipping anything, this gloss wears off faster. But still, I love it. And I don't buy too many shades into glosses. If I like a formula, I like to stick by one or two shades only. That is why I don't have like million glosses. But whatever I have, I mostly love all the glosses. And then number three is something which I'm wearing on the lips as of now. And it is a lip gloss for me, but it is a very rich gloss, which has a lot of pigment going on. So basically, even if you don't wear a lipstick, it's okay. You can just wear this. People will feel that you are wearing a lipstick, which is again topped up with a gloss, but you're not exactly wearing a lipstick, is the Kero Beauty Lip Butters. This is in the shade Pink Apple. I have Mahogany Blush also with me. I'm wearing this one today on my lips. I'm wearing it on top of a lipstick. Oh my god, this is the richest lip gloss I have in my vanity. This has like crossed the mark of lip gloss compared to many other glosses I have. This is highly pigmented. You don't need a lipstick and you're just gonna love your lips. You see how nicely done my lips are? Oh my god, they are just so well done. High on pigmentation. They are not sticky, they don't transfer here and there, they just sit well onto your lips. And the staying on these lip butters are really good. Another advice which I would like to give you, try not to wear these lip butters with an extremely drying lipstick, or else your lipstick will start getting crumpled. You can wear these on a very nice comfortable lipstick, you will like it more. But I absolutely love this one. Oh my god, I want more from this range. Just because you just can wear it by itself. So there you know, my top three into eye as well as lip category. But I must tell you, all of these products are my go-to. They are holy grails and I can just go back and repurchase them again and again. Everything will be listed and linked in my description. If you have anything to ask, do leave a comment. If you loved watching this video, consider giving a thumbs up, share the video, subscribe to my channel and follow me on my Instagram. I will see you in my next interesting video. Till then, you take care and bye bye.